let us come back and do one more NCERT question. Very interesting, easiest question, I should say. Let's see. So basically, what do they give me? Calculate the mass. I have to calculate the mass of non-volatile solute. So let us rewrite what data, given data, and what should I find out. So here they've given me calculate the mass of non-volatile solute. Molar mass is given. So I have M2, but I don't have M2. Yeah, I don't have W2. That's what is the thing given. Let's see. First of all, let us divide the solvent and your solute. W1, M1, W2, M2, PS, P0, S. Let's see. Now here did they give me, okay, solute molar mass, they said this particular solute is given molar mass, how much is given to me? 40 gram per mole. This is not given to me. I have to find the weight mass. What should be, how, which should be dissolved in 114 grams of octane. Okay, 114 grams is given to me. Molar mass of octane also is given to me. Simple. Let's come down. Now they said which should be dissolved in 114 grams of octane to reduce its VP to 80%. Okay, they said how much mass should be required to reduce the vapor pressure to 80%, they said. Now initially, if I consider your vapor pressure, original vapor pressure of the pure solvent as 1, it is, I mean, or 100, it, that is reduced to 80%. That means your PS was reduced to 80% of the original concentration. So if I take PS of 80%, that means 80% of PS or P0S. So how much is this equal to 80 by 100? That is 0.8 PA, P0S. That means if P0S is 100, that is reduced to 80% of that. So 0.8 P0S. Wherever you have PS, you can write it as 0.8 P0S. Now let's come back and solve. P0S minus PS divided by P0S is equal to, okay, N2 by N2 plus N1. This is nothing but weight by molecular weight divided by weight by molecular weight plus W1 by M1. Let's see. P0S. How much is P0S? I said it is 1. Because out of that we have picked up that 80% of that. So this is, instead of PS, 0.8 P0S divided by 1, which is equal to WT. I have to find out M2 is 40 divided by W2 by 40 plus W1. What is W1? 114. So N is equal to 114 divided by molecular weight, also 114, which is equal to 1. Write it as 1. Now substitute the W1 here. So now let's solve this. When I solve this, this becomes 1 minus 0.8 P0S. Then nothing but 0.2. Yes, 0.2 P0S. Okay, whatever it is. Let's come back. When I solve this, when I take the LCM, I get W by W plus 40. Done. Let's cross multiply. When I cross multiply, this becomes 0.2 into W. 0.2 W plus 0.2 into this 40. You're multiplying, this will become 8, isn't it? Yes, 8 is equal to W. W terms quite common. Take 8 is equal to, take W as common, make 1 minus 0.2. Just see, W into 1, W, this point, W into 0.2 becomes 0.2 W. That's simple. So when you further solve this, this becomes W into, this is 0.8. So finally, W is equal to 8 by 0.8 is nothing but 10 grams. That's it. Yes.